When survival can be measured in minutes, seconds count.
Just get someone here as quick as possible.
Yeah, okay.
They're medics on a mission.
Get all happy, MFD's an easy.
Lifting.
Okay.
Been dispatched to an incident where the arm may have been amputated.
Patient is motorcyclist to a Land Rover head on.
Cheers, boss.
9-9 visual for Land Rover.
By day and night.
He's been hit by quite a heavy object. He's unconscious and he's got arm and leg fractures.
Every day, the crews of the Yorkshire Air Ambulance.
It's a stabbing in Sheffield.
Must make critical decisions.
There's a chance of it being a walk and die.
We're going to do an anaesthetic in this fella, put him off to sleep.
For patients whose lives are in the balance.
And if that fails, we're going to make a hole in the front of his neck.
This is intensive care in mid-air.
I'm planning to put it right in the middle of that beach there.
Life-saving emergency medicine.
He rests now, off his legs.
It very much looks like we're going to have to chop his foot off.
Delivered.
The vehicle's on fire now.
At high speed. They make the difference between life.
The spinal cord has been severed.
And death.
That's the aircraft state then. Check A.
It's late morning at Air Ambulance headquarters.
Job, guys.
The team are being scrambled to a popular beach on the Yorkshire coast.
Apparently, it's a 12-year-old who's fallen off a cliff onto some rock. He's fully alert in a cave on the beach.
Paramedic Pete is responsible for finding the casualty. Dr. Sarah will lead his treatment. Pilot Andy's job is to get them there smoothly. But air turbulence means they're taking off sideways.
Where are we going?
where are we going?
I was relying on a little bit of ground effect there, which sort of manifests itself.
What are we going to?
A 12-year-old has fallen off a cliff. Jesus 15.
How far have they fallen off?
Unknown.
A 12-year-old has fallen on a beach.
Fallen off a cliff.
So we're heading to Flamborough. The injuries that we might find are just really variable. It depends on how far he's fallen. It could be actually that he's just been climbing up the rocks and fallen into water. So we might find that he's really cold. He could have had a head injury or limb injury. So if he's fallen really far, then the injuries could be really quite severe.
Tourism in Yorkshire is a £3 billion a year industry. And the beaches between Bridlington and Whitby are packed with holidaymakers today. Thankfully, coast guards have cleared the cove where the accident has happened.
Right, there's an ambulance there at the top of the hill. I'm planning to put it right in the middle of that beach there, on the right. Yep, can you see down there now?
I can, yep.
Pilot Andy faces a challenging landing. He has 200-foot cliffs on three sides. This approach will require all the skill he learned in 15 years flying for the Royal Navy.
Oh, okay, a bit of wind coming off the tops there.
Okay.
And there's no guarantee of a safe landing.
Okay. All looking good left. Steady as we come down. Hopefully the seagulls will come out of the way.
Yep.
On the Yorkshire coast, pilot Andy is fighting updrafts and seabirds to manoeuvre Helimed 99 into a rocky bay surrounded by high cliffs.
It's on the right, confirmed. That's where I'm sort of going to put it, biased towards the right there.
He's heading for a touchdown in Flamborough South Landing. It's one of Yorkshire's most photographed bays.
Okay, 10 degrees nose up, I'm happy with that. I believe it's coming down, you are clear out.
Okay, I'll
fail. Fire. Where's patient?
One of these caves over here.
So this side up there?
That side over here.
That side over there, right, OK.
The team must pick their way through the boulders that litter the bottom of the chalk cliffs.
You all right? How are you feeling? Bit rubbishy, yeah? OK.
Andrew Seavers is on holiday with his dad and stepmom.
If you just stop taking this for 2 seconds, can you just tell me what happened? Can you remember?
I fell off a ledge up there.
What, there? What were you doing up there? Were you just climbing up there?
I was following my brother. He was going up there as well.
How high up? Can you remember how high up you were?
I don't really know.
You're not really sure? And how did you land when you got to the bottom?
On my feet.
On your feet. And then did you fall over to how you are now? Okay. Can you just tell me where it hurts, where the pain is?
In the back.
In your back. Whereabouts is it?
It's somewhere.
Right at the bottom of your back, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. And have you got any pins and needles or tingling in your hands?
Yeah, this hand's really...
Just that one. What about this hand? Is that all right?
This hand's fine.
His symptoms could be a sign of a spinal injury.
What I'm just going to do is I'm just going to have a quick listen to your chest if that's all right. Just make sure that's all normal. All right, and then we'll carry you out of here. Is that all right?
He's fallen about 4 metres, something like that. He was climbing with his brother. He's fallen straight onto his feet, so he didn't bang his head at all, although he did topple over. So he's having some painkillers, and we're just going to try and get him out of here and then take him up to hospital.
Back at the helicopter, pilot Andy must prepare to get their patient back out of the bay. Landing here was difficult enough.
We don't often land on beaches, and certainly with the previous generation of helicopters, we were never sure they were going to start again. So there's always a risk if you land on a beach that the tide will come in and swamp you. We've got these new machines now, and they're so dependable and reliable that that fear has pretty much gone away.
This is what makes the job, doesn't it?
It's very special indeed. I mean, we're very fortunate that the terrain around Yorkshire is phenomenal and the beaches are probably some of the most spectacular in the country. So to get an opportunity like this on a beautiful sunny Sunday to land on the beach and to help somebody is truly a privilege.
One more kayak is out there, Andy. You'll go over as you come in.
Yeah, I'll make my approach on this one.
There's a lot of cliffs around, so that generates a certain amount of turbulence. We're quite fortunate at this time in the morning. The wind's offshore. So as we come in, we're into wind, and it's a relatively straightforward approach. And we've also had good communications with the Coast Guard, so they were able to clear the beach and get some of the kayakers out of the way. So the approach is relatively straightforward.
Andrew's going to be flown 15 miles to A&E in Scarborough. The local Coast Guards, most of them volunteers, are lending the team a hand.
How you doing, Andrew?
Fine.
You all right? Is this arm still feeling funny?
No, it's better.
It's better now, OK.
Weird feeling in his arm's actually come back to normal now, which is great news. So he's just got this back pain, which we've given him some painkillers for, so he's feeling much brighter. So we're going to fly him up out of here now and take him to Scarborough, and his stepmom's going to come with us, and then Dad's going to meet us at the hospital.
This isn't the way the family thought their day out would end.
Have you been in a helicopter before? OK, it's extremely noisy and it's extremely vibratory. OK, so it does feel a bit odd, but you're going to be absolutely fine. All right.
Pilot Andy is reversing out of the cove, keeping the helicopter facing into the sea breeze. It means if there's an emergency, he can land back on the beach.
We're very fortunate because it looks like the wind is coming straight away from it, so unfortunately also a bit light, I feel.
You all right, Andrew? Yeah, good man.
Their patient is heading for x-rays and scans. The results could be life-changing.
Can you just tell me what happened? Can you remember?
I fell off a ledge up there.
Doctors ruled out a spinal injury in the case of 12-year-old Andrew, injured in a cliff fall. But he did break his ankle.